gather here as God's people, let us gather knowing of his love, but also those times in our lives when we do not return that love to others or to God. Lord, for the times I have forgotten to pray, Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you come to us in so many ways, bringing your love and your care, your forgiveness and mercy. Help us this day to remember that you come to us in a special way through the Eucharist that we will receive. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We sit down, except for the Epiphany, which begins in our first reading. Will they make you a sandwich? or will you have a little snack? Well, I always remember when I used to get home from school, I was really hungry. And my mum always made me a jam sandwich. The jam sandwich of some buttered white bread. Very tasty. And it did me until I got my tea. We only had white bread in those days, and I was in Tesco's the other day, and I looked at the shelves, how things have changed. The types of bread that we can have together today is just amazing, really. There's that white bread that everybody would know. Good standard. Not very healthy for you, though, is it? But it's nice to have as a treat. Then, of course, there's a much more healthy option. Ah, there it is. Brown wholemeal bread. Seeded bread. Now, this is what I eat mainly these days. But when I want a treat, I'll go back to the white stuff. So you go back to the bread. Then if you fancy something a bit more wholesome, again, not very healthy, some crumpets. Oh, nothing like a crumpet with a bit of butter on it and bouncing oozing through. Very tasty. Again, not very healthy. Something if you're maybe out one evening and you're at the local Indian, you'll have some naan bread. Very tasty, dipped into a curry, mopping up those juices. Making me hungry now. Mopping up those juices. So many different types of bread. And then if you're having an Italian, some ciabatta. Some ciabatta. Very tasty again. Especially when you're maybe eating some pasta and pasta sauce. For a special treat, croissant or pain au chocolat. Pain au chocolat. All those very different types of bread to feed us, to nurture our bodies, to make them grow, to make them strong. Jesus in the gospel today tells us that he is the bread of life. And whoever eats of his bread and drinks of this cup, his body and blood, will have eternal life. And then, of course, there is the simple bread that we use at the celebration of Mass. And this bread will become for us today the body of Christ. And the wine which we brought up will become the blood of Christ. And it will nourish us. Nourish us, yes, very simply, as any bread would. But because it becomes the body of Christ, it will nourish our hearts. And it will nourish our minds. And it will draw us ever closer to God, who is our Father. It is lovely that today you will be receiving that bread of life at the very first time. You know how you come to church up until that, you've always done that when you come to communion. You don't need to do that today or anymore. You will present, I will say the body of Christ, and you will say,
Amen.
You will take, and you will eat, and you will make the disciples. And isn't that great? And you know what? When you come to church again next week, you won't have to do that. You'll be able to receive from you any time you wish to come to church. And just as Jesus shares his life with us, who wants some brown bread? Who wants some brown bread? Who wants the crumpets? flatter.
And who wants the white bread? Go and take it to your family.
That
we now sit down and continue with our celebration of Mass. The children will come with the basket for you to make your offerings to the church if you wish to do so. If you haven't brought any cash today, you can use the credit card, please, at the back. Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and to your hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands. Praise and glory his name.
God our Father, we thank you for all the gifts you give to us in our lives, the gifts of friendship, the gifts of love, the gifts of peace. You give us today these gifts of bread and wine. Make them acceptable so that they may become for us the body and blood of Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
God our loving Father, we are glad to give you thanks and praise because you love us. Because you love us, you have given us this great and beautiful world. Because you love us, you sent Jesus, your Son, to bring us to you and to gather us around him as the children of one family. For such great love, we now thank you with all the angels and saints as they praise you and sing. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Blessed be Jesus, who you said to be a friend of all people, especially the poor, the lonely and sick. He came to show us that we can love you, Father, by loving one another. He came to take away sin, which keeps us from being friends, and hate, which makes the world an unhappy place. He promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us always, so that we can live as your children. God, our Father, we now ask you to send your Holy Spirit to change these gifts of bread and wine into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night before he died, when he was in suffering with his disciples and his friends, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink of it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
And so, loving Father, we remember that Jesus died and rose again to save our world. He put himself into our hands to be the sacrifice that we offer you. Lord, our God, listen to our prayers. Send the Holy Spirit to all of us who are here together. May this Spirit bring us closer together in the family of the Church, with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember, Father, our families and our friends, and those we do not love as we should. Remember those who have died. Bring them home to you all to be with you forever. And gather us all together into your kingdom. There we shall be happy forever with Mary, the Virgin Mother, the God and our Mother. And there all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing to you a song of joy.
Through heaven, within and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
So we now stand and sing together the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. So teaches us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I will follow you, that you should enter under my roof. Though you say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Children who are making their first Holy Communion today, I will call out individually each by name. As I mentioned, if you wish to take a photograph, when that has happened, please do. Once we finish distributing Holy Communion to the children, the rest of you can receive communion. If it is your custom to receive communion in the Catholic Church, then please do as you usually would. Do not receive communion or cannot for any reason, you're welcome to come forward for a blessing, letting myself or the minister know that you wish to receive a blessing. So I invite Claudia to receive Holy Communion for the very first time. Thank you.
By the way,
have spelled any of these wrong, let me know. Lorenzo? Joseph? Aaron? Persephone?
다 이러냐 싶어.
저희 다